Children, in the last class we have discussed about different uses of microorganism. In today's class we will discuss about the medicinal use of microorganism. What are the medicinal uses of microorganism? Mainly these microorganisms are used in the preparation of antibiotics as well as vaccines. These two are the very good examples of medicinal use of microorganism in the preparation of antibiotics as well as vaccines. First, we have to discuss about what are antibiotics. These antibiotics are the medicines which kill or stop the growth of disease-causing microorganisms. What are antibiotics? These are the medicines which kill or stop the growth of disease-causing microorganisms in our body. Okay, the medicines which kill or stop the growth of disease-causing microorganisms, such medicines are called antibiotics. There are number of antibiotics being produced from bacteria and fungi. Usually the antibiotics are prepared by using bacteria as well as fungi. Nowadays mainly the bacteria and fungi are used to prepare antibiotics. Examples for antibiotics are penicillin, streptomycin, tetracycline and erythromycin. That is penicillin, streptomycin, tetracycline and erythromycin. These are the examples of different antibiotics prepared from bacteria and fungi. This very important antibiotic, that is penicillin, you might have heard about that penicillin. That penicillin was discovered by the scientist, that is Alexander Fleming. He prepared that penicillin in the year 1929. You go through Alexander Fleming, you collect information about the scientist Alexander Fleming, you will get the detail of how he prepared the antibiotic penicillin. Okay, and you collect the information about Alexander Fleming. That is one activity I will give for you. How to collect the information of Alexander Fleming. The antibiotics are manufactured by growing specific microorganisms and are used to cure variety of diseases. These antibiotics are even mixed with the feed of livestock and poultry to check microbial infections. Okay, these are the different uses of antibiotics. These antibiotics are mainly prepared by the bacteria and fungi. They kill or they stop the growth of microorganism in the body. While taking antibiotics, you should remember some of the points. This antibiotic should be taken by the advice of a qualified doctor. A doctor should advise that some antibiotics to kill some of the microorganism, to control some of the diseases, that should be taken only by the advice of the doctor, qualified doctor. These antibiotics should be taken only by the advice of the qualified doctor. If you take unnecessarily these antibiotics, it may kill some of the beneficial bacteria in our body, and in the future it will not be effective. That's why you should not take the antibiotics unnecessarily. You should complete the course of antibiotics prescribed by the doctor. How many days they will prescribe, that should be completed. Course of antibiotics should be completed. These are the points you should remember while taking the antibiotic. First one is, it should be taken by the advice of the qualified doctor. Then you should complete the course of antibiotics prescribed as prescribed by the doctor, and you should not take unnecessarily the antibiotics, because they may kill some of the beneficial microorganisms in our body. These are the points should be remembered while taking the before taking the antibiotics. This is about antibiotics. These microorganisms are used in the preparation of antibiotics. Next, we will discuss about another one used medicinally in the preparation of vaccine. Now, we will discuss what is vaccine and how the vaccine will work. You might have heard about that children are given vaccine to control some of the diseases. Okay, what are vaccine? When a disease carrying microbe enters our body, when a disease causing microbe enters to our body, the body produces antibody to fight against invader. Invader means what? A disease causing microbes in the body. The body also remembers how to fight the microbe if it enters again. The body will remember if the microorganism again enters to our body, how to fight against that. If dead or weakened microbes are introduced into a healthy body, the body fights and kills the invading bacteria by producing suitable antibodies. The antibodies remain in the body and we are protected from the disease causing microbes forever. I think you understood. If dead or weakened microbes are introduced into a healthy body, those dead or weakened microbes, that means the microbes should be weakened or made dead in the laboratory, those microbes should be introduced into the healthy body. Then what happens when you introduce those dead or weakened microbes into the body? What happens? The body fights and kills the invading bacteria. That body fights against and kills that invading bacteria by producing suitable antibodies. Body will produce some other antibodies. The antibodies remain in the body and we are protected from the disease causing microbes forever. This is how the vaccine works. Examples for vaccines. Some of the vaccines are there. For example, cholera, tuberculosis, smallpox and hepatitis can be prevented by providing vaccine. These diseases, not examples for vaccine, these are the diseases, they can be prevented by providing vaccines. This very good example for vaccine, that is smallpox. The vaccine for smallpox was discovered by the scientist Edward Jenner. You heard about his name? That is Edward Jenner. He discovered the vaccine for smallpox in the year 1798. And you have to collect another one activity. You have to collect information about Edward Jenner. Now what you have to collect? Alexander Fleming and Edward Jenner. You have to collect the information about these two scientists. I think you heard about the Pulse Polio program in the TV advertisement regarding the Pulse Polio program in TV as well as in the newspaper. You know about that children are given polio drops to prevent the polio disease. See, polio drops are given to children are actually a vaccine, and that with the help of that program, that is Pulse Polio program. These are mainly made by microorganism. They help to kill some of the disease causing microbes. These are the vaccine. Vaccines are prepared by microorganism. These microorganisms are help to protect the animal as well as human being from the different diseases. These doctors will give vaccines or antibiotic to protect the organism from infections or diseases, variety of diseases. Okay, this is about the medicinal use of microorganism. Okay, what are the main medicinal uses of that is in the preparation of antibiotics and in the preparation of vaccine, these microorganisms are used. Activity what I have given, I will not give that activity once again in the group. What you have to collect information regarding Alexander Fleming as well as Edward Jenner. Okay, you have to collect photo and you have to make activity in the A4 size paper. Okay, you take A4 size paper, one corner you paste photo of Alexander Fleming and Edward Jenner, and in front of that you write the information regarding the Edward Jenner and Alexander Fleming. This is the activity you should do. Okay, if you have any doubt, you can ask. Thank you. Other things we will continue in the next class. Till now we discussed about friendly microorganism. Next, in the next class, we will discuss about a harmful microorganism. Mainly what are the diseases caused by microorganism we have to discuss. Thank you.